So at a time when homes aren't necessarily just selling themselves, a lot more people are looking to remodel their existing homes. And so you always want to try to find a way to do it on a budget. Sue Monday from Home Depot joining us now. And what's interesting about this setup that you have here is you're comparing some expensive to some cheaper options, and they really look very similar.
Very similar. You can almost have the same look. We based all the pricing on a typical 10 by 10 kitchen.
Okay.
And if you used a special order product, this is American Woodmark door.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
This is actual Bruce hardwood, and this is travertine and granite countertops.
And those are some of the, you know, real contemporary popular looks
stuff.
This would be high end.
Okay.
If you did this kitchen, it would run about $12,000. If you did this kitchen using an in-stock cabinet, laminate floors, and a ceramic tile instead of using all the other, the more natural mm-hmm. stuff.
And then what would you use for the countertop?
This is ceramic as well? That's actually called that silestone, and it's granite ground up and put together with polymer.
Okay.
So it looks almost exactly the same.
It looks really similar.
It does.
So there are just a lot of cheaper alternatives that are out there. You just need to do a little homework and probably ask a few extra questions while you're there.
Exactly. And going to appliances. This is stainless steel. GE has come out with a product called New Steel.
Mm-hmm.
It actually, you can put magnets on it where you can't put magnets on stainless. Looks very much the same, and you're going to save about $100 per unit.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a refrigerator, $100 less.
Okay, so on the high-end kitchen we were talking about, if we go back to that for a second, you're talking about $12,000.
$12,000.
And what was the alternative here with some of the lower alternatives?
With this, you could save $8,000. Almost
$4,000. Say $3,600,
yeah.
So it was $8,500 total. So when Deirdre was talking about, so is it really when you go in to do these types of things, do you have to kind of know your P's and Q's, know what to ask, or do you just say, hey, I want the cheaper option always?
Well, not necessarily. I mean, people have a look in mind.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe they get the bid for this and they go, oh, gosh, I can't afford that.
Mm-hmm.
So let's look at some options. How can we get a product that looks very much similar and you can get the same look for much less money?
I'm sorry. Are you finding a lot of people are, you know, rather than kind of playing the California house game where you're moving every couple of years into a bigger house, are people just trying to make the place they've got just what it is that they're hoping to have anyway?
We're actually seeing that a lot right
mm-hmm.
now. People can't sell their homes, and so they're going, oh, well, we're stuck here. We want to make it a happy home. You know, we're tired of looking at the same cabinetry.
So we've talked a little bit about the appliances and cabinets and flooring stuff. What about paint?
Paint is the cheapest thing that you can do
mm-hmm.
to freshen up your house. And right now, Home Depot has come out with a new paint. It's called Fresh Air. It actually emits no VOCs. So you can paint that room and actually sleep in it. You will not have the smell of paint in your room at all. And this
it's probably good, actually, for people who have small children.
It's mm-hmm. and asthma
uh-huh.
and allergies. Wonderful. There's absolutely no paint or smell. And the can is actually made out of recycled product, 75%
recycled.
Perfect
for Earth Day.
Perfect for Earth Day.
Sue, thanks for joining us on this day.